Hello everyone, welcome. In the previous video, we began with how to create a Google quiz. Now, let's continue with our working. So again, we have opened Google Forms here, and this is the quiz that we had created by name of Demo Quiz. Once we click here, the quiz that we were creating gets opened. Now, if you remember, we had entered the name, roll number, and class for our students, and then we had added another section where we had just entered one particular question pertaining to the multiple choice answers of yes or no. Now let's try and add an image for a question. I'll just open this question once to show one more option here. Now we understand that there may be some situations where we want our students to be very judicious and be very sincere towards attempting a quiz. So one particular option that Google provides us is by shuffling the option order. If we click here, we have the option of shuffle option order. So that means if a student opens a Google quiz for the first question, he or she will be able to see the options of A, B and C, D in shuffled manner, and student B will see them in a different manner. The same question, the same options, but just the order would be shuffled. Since here we had just two options of yes or no, so in this question it won't be very advisable to shuffle the option order, but maybe in the questions where we have more than three, four options, so there shuffling can be possible. Now let's try add another question in which we'll add an image. Now, for example, we want to write down here, identify the personality, and here we have the option of adding an image. Once we click here, we can select the image either if we have saved it in our systems by clicking on the browse button. We can directly take an image from here. We can directly take a picture. We can directly have a URL. We can select it from the photos already available on our Google Drive. We can select some content from our drive as well. Or we can go for Google image search. So let us try with Google image search here. For example, we select for an image of the former US president, Barack Obama. Now from here we select the image and we click on insert. So the very first image that we had selected will get inserted here in our Google quiz. Now we also have the options of reducing the size of the image or for moving the image. First of all, here is the option. If we click these three options, we have the left alignment, center align, right align. We can also change the image if we want, and also we can remove it. It is also possible to add a caption. Now, in case we want to reduce or increase the size, we simply click on the image and we'll have this blue border, and we can simply use the drag and drop feature so that we can increase or decrease the size of the respective image. Now, from here, as you can see, it has been resized. Again, if we click, we can see that the image has been placed here. Now, students can be given an option for selecting that which particular personality is being shown in the image. So here some options can be added. Again, we can have the answer key and we can add on the different options, the correct answer for the particular question. Now scrolling above, if we talk about some of these settings, so this was about that how we can create a quiz, how we can add different sections to a quiz. Now let's talk about some settings, particularly beginning with the theme of a Google quiz. Customized theme option is available in form of a color palette symbol here. Once we click on it, we can see that we already have some theme colors available to us. We can select any particular theme. For example, if we click on red, so you can see the color of the Google form has changed. We can also have some image. There are different kinds of image templates available for work in school, illustrations, for birthdays, food and dining, and so on. Then we can pick up any theme and we can add any kind of theme in our respective page. Now, for example, in the Google quiz we are working with, we take up this particular image and we can simply click on insert. So we can see that the theme has been updated here and the image has been inserted. We can also change the theme color, the background color. And if we scroll down, we have four different font styles as basic, decorative, formal, and playful. We can pick up any one of them as desired. So this was about the themes of the Google quiz. Now, whatever quiz we have created so far, we can also have a preview of the quiz. If we click here, we'll be able to see that how this quiz will appear for students. Now, as you can see, we had mentioned the demo quiz, then we had marked the option of name as required. This asterisk on the top is actually reflecting that it is a required question and a student will not be able to submit unless and until he or she fills in this particular column. So name, roll number, class, and we had selected the response on in form of the drop-down menu. The student can select the class as BA1, BCom1 or BSc1. Now when a student clicks on next, then he or she will be able to begin working with the quiz. For now, if we click on next, it won't work because we have not filled in any of these mandatory options. Now let us go back to our quiz and explore other options available to us. Next, we have some settings. If we click on these settings, the very first setting available to us is that we can collect some general email responses from the students. That is, any person who is attempting the quiz will have to enter the email address. Now, it is also possible that a student can have the response receipts with him or her on the email ID that he or she has mentioned in the Google form. Now, it is here option available that if the respondent would request, only then he or she would be able to have the entire responses that he or she has marked in the Google quiz. Or do you want to make it as default setup? That is, whenever a student will attempt the quiz, he or she will certainly receive that what responses he or she has marked in his or her Gmail ID. Another thing is that in case we do not want students to repeatedly attempt a quiz to avoid duplication, we have this option of limit to one response. But for this, it is very important that students have to be informed in prior that they will have to sign in to Google. Only then they'll be able to attempt the quiz. Without signing in with their Gmail ID, they will not be able to attempt the quiz here. Also, we have certain options where we want that the respondents can either they can edit after the submission has been made. Since we are making it a quiz, so it is advisable not to check mark this button of edit after submit. If you want the students should be able to see the summary chart and text responses, then we can check mark this particular box as well. So this was about the basic settings of the general settings for a quiz. Now let's move on to some presentation settings. The first is the progress bar. That means depending upon that how many sections are there in the quiz and what all sections a student has completed, he or she will be able to see the progress. Then again, in order to avoid any kind of falsification by students, we have another option of shuffle question order, in which all the questions might get shuffled. So every student will have different first question appearing on his or her screen. But please make sure that when we are making a quiz, so we should not number the questions, because in that case, if the order will shuffle, the numbers would also get shuffled. So if we have added the question without entering any question number, then of course, shuffle question order is advisable. And after the student submits the response, he or she can reflect, see a message that your response has been recorded. And this can be altered here. We can change this message if we want to. For example, we want to write that the result will be displayed on this particular date. It can be done here very easily. The third setting that we can make is regard to the quizzes, where first thing, if we want that the grades should be released immediately after a student has filled in the Google quiz, or if we want to release the scores later on, then it is also possible to see that students can actually be able to see the missed questions, the correct answers, and the point values. Now, if we want to release the grade after manual review, so it is suggested that we do not see the correct answers and the point values here, and we click on save. So these were some of the settings for a Google quiz. Now, after settings, let's see that once the quiz has been created, all the desired settings have been made, where we have added the number of questions to the quiz. We have assigned the point values to the quiz. If we want to see that how can this quiz be shared, we can click on send. And we have three options of sharing the particular Google quiz with the respondents. The very first is, in case we have the email IDs of all the students, the quiz can be specifically mailed to them by adding any particular message, and we can simply click on the send button. Another option is that we can have a link. As you can see, the link has already been generated. Since we understand that it becomes tedious to have such a long link, so it provides us an option of shortening the URL. Once we click on shorten URL, so you can see that this is being shown. The third option is that the form can be sent by embedding it to the HTML page. It can also be done. So generally, the feature that is used most for getting the responses to a quiz are using the link. So this link can either be shared with students through a WhatsApp group, or it can be shared on any kind of Google Classroom or a Moodle or any other platform where we want the students to respond to the quiz. We can simply click on copy and then we can paste it anywhere we want to. Now, the quiz that we have created, we had added only one question here, and we had assigned a point value to it of 1 point. That is why when we are scrolling to the top of this page, we can see here the total points. That means this quiz has been created for 1 point only. We have not yet added any kind of marks to this photo of identify the personality, this question. Now, just to identify, we can also have some questions where we can leave some questions with marks, and we can have some questions where we do not want the students to have some marks specifically attached to it. It is also possible here. Again, if you want to add another question, we have the plus sign. If we feel that question has been added at a wrong place, it can simply be dragged and it can be brought down and dropped here so that the sequence of questions is set. Now, besides talking about that, how it can be shared and how some settings can be made, we also have some features where we can either undo the recent change that has been made in the Google quiz. We can make a copy of the quiz. In case a wrong quiz or major mistakes have been done, it can be simply deleted by move to trash option. Then another important feature is add collaborators. Now, for example, there are two faculty members who want to work on the responses of a particular quiz. Or if a person wants that another faculty member should make some editings in the quiz that have been made. So we can simply click on add collaborator. It will ask us for the email ID of the person with whom we want to collaborate. So we can simply enter the email ID. For example, if I enter this ID here. Now, again, we have some options that whether we want the person to be editor here or not. By default, the person to whom we are inviting will be able to edit, and the editor will also be able to view as well as delete any kind of form responses. We can add a message as well and click on send. So this was about how do we add a collaborator. Now, if we talk about some more settings here, we also have the option of getting the Google quiz printed, and we can also have a pre-filled link for the Google quiz that we had just created. So these were some more features of how we can work on a Google quiz. In the next video, we'll talk about that how the responses can be seen and saved in our systems. Till then, stay tuned, everyone. Thank you.